get ready to match the star, Sheldon Leonard, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Louisa Moritz, Richard Dawson, and Fatty Flack as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game, PM. And now here's the star of Match Game PM, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you very much, Johnny Olsen and friends.
All right, Big Eddie.
Here comes trouble.
You're finished. Get out of town.
Do you mind if I clean up a couple of details first, like nailing your feet to the ground, something like that?
Are you all quite ready?
Yeah!
Boy, are you ready? All right. Let's say hello to our two players over here, Leonard Bernstein and Kathy Ritter. Now, we're delighted to have both of you with us. We wish you both well and ask you in turn, beginning with Kathy, to tell us a little bit about yourselves.
Okay, I've been married 2 years to a super nifty guy. We make our home in Long Beach, and I'm employed by a major international airline.
Okay, nice to have you with us, Kathy. Now, you say Leonard Bernstein.
That's me.
You pronounce it differently from the conductor who prefers Bernstein.
That's to tell us apart.
Oh, that's so you can fall. You are not musical, I take it?
Not at all.
Yes, we mustn't confuse him with the conductor now. You will remember that. Okay. Where are you from, Leonard?
About 30 years ago from Cleveland, but now I'm living in Van Nuys, California.
Yep. You like it there?
Very much so.
Okay. You're married?
I'm married to a beautiful girl named Gloria, and I have two teenage sons, Alan and Richard.
Okay. Good luck to both of you. I remind both of you that you'll be trying to match as many of our celebrities as you can, and then the winner goes on to play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $10,000. Kathy, we will ask you to make the selection. You want A or B?
B, please.
B it is. Here we go. Arthur said, he says, I've just discovered a great cure for snoring.
How pure is it?
He said, whenever my wife snores, I stick my blank in her mouth. Whenever my wife snores, I stick my blank in her mouth. Big Brother is watching every move you make. Okay. Splendid. Okay. All right. Ready, everybody? Ready. All right. Ready.
I guess there's only one answer to that, isn't there?
I suppose so. Give us your second choice and everything will be all right, Kathy. Now, Arthur said, I've just discovered a great cure for snoring. Whenever my wife snores, I stick my blank in her mouth.
Pillow.
Pillow is a good answer. She's got the idea. Sheldon, have you got the idea?
I got the idea, but I ain't got a pillow, so in the absence of a pillow, I stick my fist in
fist
my mouth.
Fist is good. That's okay. All right. See, he doesn't sleep with a pillow. That's why he stands so straight and tall that way. What do you say?
Well, I don't know how a girl from Portland, Maine like myself could get so violent. I said clenched fist.
Clenched fist. So that's two of those and no pillows.
I know how, because you're a toughie like he is. You're both toughies.
And we're sick of you.
I chose a feathered pillow.
A pillow. Excuse me for just a second here. Is this your gym?
No, it isn't.
Well, whose is it?
It ain't mine.
It's
I've got mine hidden up here.
Oh, all right. Well, whatever it is, I was afraid I was going to kick it over. Can we just leave it there? Do you mind?
I ordered them.
No eating or drinking on the set. You know the rules now. Lois, show us your card there.
Since she's going, it's going to be in her mouth.
Yes.
And, well, I think of a... Thumb.
Oh, yeah, like... Okay. Arthur said I've just discovered a great cure for snoring. Whenever my wife snores, I stick my pillow in her mouth, according to Kathy Ritter. What do you say?
Well, I do a lot of traveling on major airlines.
Where?
On the major airlines.
On the major airlines, yes.
Well, always very nice to me.
You know, he gave me my very first job in the
country. He gave you your first job?
Carl Reiner took me in and said, you have to read for Sheldon, but he's very critical, so do a good job.
Yeah.
I was very nervous, and I went in. He said, how are you going to play this character? I said, well, I thought I'd say, oh, hello, lovies. He said, you got the job. I also said pillow.
Pillow. Yeah. Yeah. Listen, you know, you do him better than he does him. Would you rehearse yourself, Sheldon? You really don't sound like your old self. Now, Fanny, we're up to you. Whenever my wife snores, I stick a pillow in her mouth. What do you say?
Me and my nephew, Charles, always say feathered pillow.
Pillow! There it is. That's not bad for first round, is it? First round was a little tougher. She did well. Leonard, we'll see how you do. It's Leonard Bernsteinstein who is now up there. You ready, Leonard? Okay. In the Garden of Eden, Adam said, I can't believe it. Last night was my first night in paradise, and Eve came to bed with a blank.
Oh, I've got so many terrific answers for that. I'll have to hear it again.
Last night.
She came to bed with a blank. Sounds
in the Garden of Eden. In the Garden of Eden, Adam said, I can't believe it. Last night was my first night in paradise, and Eve came to bed with a... And it's entirely up to you. Are you thinking about that, Leonard? Don't say it yet until we tell you to say it. Yes? It's all right. Okay. Terrific. Now, wait a minute. These three are ready.
You're all ready.
Oh, you are such perfect people. It's frightening.
We're just zipping along.
Now, Leonard Bernsteinstein.
Yes.
You play any musical instruments?
Very little piano. I mean, very little.
Really? Hum for us. Hum something. That's very good. See how musical he is? All right. In the Garden of Eden, Adam said, I can't believe it. Last night was my first night in paradise, and Eve came to bed with a...
Apple.
Apple. Really? I don't think that happened on the first night. You have read the Bible.
Yes.
You have.
That's how he got her into bed, I think.
Yeah, that's how he got... No.
She got him into
that's
bed.
That's right.
Well, who's counting?
What did you say? He said apple.
Well, the guy who gave her the apple was the original snake.
Yes, you're holding it up. The snake is upside down.
I do that. I'm holding those snakes upside down.
Okay, the snake. She came to bed with a snake, he said.
A snake?
Yes, he said apple. What?
Eve was a child woman.
She was
Yes, she came to bed with her teddy bear.
Oh, isn't that sweet? Yes.
You like that answer, Charles?
Last night was my first night in paradise. Eve came to bed with an apple.
She might have had the snake and a teddy bear, but she had one heck of a headache.
That's the popular favorite, Charles. Well, of course, now that's the old joke, Leonard, you say. I'm sorry, dear, I've got a headache tonight there, and that's what she said. What did you say?
Well, she came to bed with a snake, a teddy bear, a headache, and a monkey.
Her monkey?
She always takes her monkey to bed.
Really? Were there monkeys in the Garden of Eden?
Well, sure.
Don't explain it now, Louisa, but what does that mean?
Sure, there was. Don't explain it now, there.
Don't
little monkey business
now.
In the Garden of Eden there. Last night was my first night in paradise. Eve came to bed with a apple, according to Leonard there. What have you got?
Well, it would be a bummer if she came to bed with a headache.
Yes, of course.
And even worse bummer if she came to bed with a friend.
Right. Okay. Now, we're up to danger high explosives over there.
I think I'll kill myself.
We'll all go together.
Lighter fuse. Yes, last night, Eve came to bed with a...
I say not tonight, Adam. I've got a terrible headache.
A headache, okay. So what do we got here? End of round one scores 3-0 in favor of Kathy. Round two coming up in a little bit, but right now this is coming your way. Round two coming up. Round two questions revealed. Now, where are we? 3-0. She's ahead, so Leonard, we ask you to make your selection now.
A, please.
What? Oh, she's ahead. She makes a selection. That's the way it goes. All right, Kathy, you're ahead, so you make the selection.
Well, then I'll take B, please.
Oh, you want B. All right, anything you say.
Honey, didn't you rehearse this first?
No, no, it's a very loose show.
She's
Willie said.
Whizzikers.
Willie said, I went to Dr. Quackenbush for a liver transplant. And is he weird? Oh, listen, no, I'm sorry. No, if that's all the heart you're going to put into it, get out. Get out! Yeah. You know, one more chance. Wait a minute. Should we give him another chance? All right. This is your last chance. Willie said, I went to Dr. Quackenbush for a liver transplant, and is he weird?
How weird is he?
Okay, you can stay. Before he put in my new liver, he blanked it.
Got it.
Got it? Is he weird? Before he put in my new liver, he blanked it.
Oh, I love my answer. Whatever it is I'm doing here.
Three people don't write. You don't write, you don't write.
Do I write a lot?
You don't write. Because she matched three people in her first round question. Sheldon's finished. Yes, Brett, you write and you're finished. And Louisa is finished hers. So here we go with Kathy Ritter. Willie said, I went to Dr. Quackenbush for a liver transplant, and is he weird? Before he put in my liver, he blanked it.
Cooked it.
He cooked it.
What did she say?
She said, before he put in my liver, he cooked it.
Jump through that.
What do you say, Sheldon?
Yeah, I say that she broiled it.
Broiled and cooked. There's a match. One for Kathy.
All right. What else is there to do with liver besides fry it with bacon and onions?
Fry it with bacon and onions! Well, Kathy's up to 5. Now, Louisa, before this liver transplant, is he weird? Before he put in my new liver, he blanked it, and according to Kathy, he cooked it.
Well, I didn't go that far, but I said he marinated it.
You know?
Don't you marinate liver before you cook it?
No, you don't.
You just throw it in?
You're weirder than the doctor in the card here. All right, so that's 5 for Kathy. Now, Leonard, you've got to match 5 to stay in the game. However, if you match all 6 of the ding-a-lings here, you're going to win the game. Let's see what happens. Marge wanted to attract Eskimo men, so she wore a perfume called Eau de Blanc. That's E-A-U-D-D-E blanc. Eau de Blanc.
Eau de Blanc.
Eau de Blanc.
Eau de Blanc.
Eau de Blanc. Very good. Everybody plays. All right. Good. Finished up there. Just put in the slot, Charles. Do not hesitate. He who hesitates is...
dead.
All right.
No, darling, lost.
Are they all red? Okay, he who hesitates is lost, as the phrase goes. All right, Leonard, are you ready for this?
I'm ready.
Listen, think carefully now. Marge wanted to attract Eskimo men, so she wore a perfume called Eau de... You know, it's E-A-U, de. What do you say there?
Whale.
Eau de whale. Very good, according to the audience. 5 whales, Leonard, will tie the score. 6 whales will...
5 whales make 1 blimp.
5 whales win.
Make 1 blimp.
Yeah. You're going downhill rapidly there. Sheldon, what do you say?
I suppose you're going to give me a big argument about this.
I'll argue with you, Sheldon.
But there's a very close relationship between whales and walruses. And I said walrus. Now,
a whale is not a walrus. Not in our lexicon, a whale
I'll
is not
I'll meet
a
all
walrus.
You guys outside.
Who's that? Is that Gus or Deidre on the butter? A buzzer.
The butter?
On the butter. Is that Gus on the butter? A buzzer? Okay, what do you say?
If it was Deidre, it was butter, right?
That's
but if
right.
it was Gus, it's buzzer.
Right.
Would I let a famous musical conductor down?
Yes.
What is like whale? Whale.
Whale! Yeah. Okay, you got to match the others, Leonard. Charles, would you let
a musical conductor down?
I said walrus like Big Eddie.
Oh.
What have the rest of you got?
Blubber.
Blubber.
Well, okay, congratulations. You stand by there for a moment or so. Well, Mr. Leonard Bernstein Stein, we got a part company. It was a pleasure meeting you. I hope you'll keep singing and keep humming. We've got gifts for you, together with our thanks for being with us. Leonard Bernstein. While he's spinning off, we're going to spin this message for you, so you come right back. Ready? She's won her first game. And, Kathy, it's time now for the Big Money Super Match where you can win over $10,000. Now, to do that, we have two audience matches for you. Whatever you win in these audience matches, you'll have a chance to multiply by 10. Are you ready?
Right.
Good. Here we go. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Out of the blank. Out of the blank. Now, if you match the answer that audience gave most often, you get $500. If you match the answer they gave second most frequently, you get $250. And if you match their third most frequently given response, you get $100. Whom do you call on here for a little help?
Charles, please.
You're permitted three. Charles is the first. What do you say? He's thinking. Out of the...
A boring answer. Out of the can.
Yes. Listen, if you're going to...
Notice how guilty the housewives in the audience are.
Yes, that's the ladies who are... Now, just as in the applause, dear friends, if you're going to boo, do it with gusto and with heart. Now, say the answer again. That's enough.
An old army slogan.
Yes. All right, you got another one.
Brett, please.
Brett.
Well, what about out of the frying pan?
Out of the frying pan. You got
well,
two.
Well, that's better than out of the can. Right.
Richard.
Richard.
Out of the blue.
Out of the blue. Did that tell you something? What?
Out of the blue.
Out of the blue is what you want. Did you think of any others?
Out of the money.
Out of the money? I think that would have gotten you out of the money if you said that. Out of the blue is the one she wants, and of course, she hopes it's under the $500 response, but as usual, we will begin down at the bottom and reveal in order. First, the $100 response. Out of the ordinary. We had a...
That was Charles's answer. Out of the ordinary.
Out of the ordinary. He didn't think of that. Now, we're looking for out of the blue. Let's find out if out of the blue is under the $250 response. Out of the way. Was this a difficult one? None of us thought of those or said them, did we? All right, last chance here, Kathy, for out of the blue. May we see the $500 response? Out of the blue. Congratulations. All right. Kathy, you won $500. Which means the least amount you'll be playing for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. But now, let's see how much more you can win with the second audience match. Earl, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. He has to switch the things inside there, you see.
Takes time.
That's right. We polled the recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Continental blank.
Oh, okay,
all right, remember, 5, 250, and 100. Three are permitted to help. Who are they?
Fanny, please.
Continental Divide.
Continental Divide.
Who's there for my answer?
That's because you got a lot of nature lovers in the audience here.
Brett, please.
Brett?
How about Continental Airlines?
Continental Airlines.
Well, thank you.
They're letting you know, don't they?
Richard, please.
Richard?
Continental Breakfast. You got me on.
Continental Breakfast is a popular slogan for people who travel a lot. What do you say? Continental Breakfast, Continental Divide, or Continental Airlines?
I better go for airlines.
Airlines. Okay. So that's Continental Airlines. That's the one she wants. We'll find out if it's up there. Is it under the $100 response, I ask you? Continental Divide is the one that Fanny gave you. Okay, it's there. That may be a good omen, Kathy. Let us reveal the $250 response. Continental Breakfast. That's just the order we got the answers in, isn't it? All right. No, not quite. Let's see. Last chance for Continental Airlines. Here we go.
Oh, my God.
You want to kiss somebody? Kiss him. That makes her feel better. She got so excited she just had to kiss somebody, so we figured we better let her kiss Big Eddie there.
I have a very deep voice.
Now, you want another 500? We multiply that by 10, gives you an additional 5,000, add it to the previous 5,000, which means you're shooting for a pot of $10,000. Yeah. Now to collect, you gotta match one celebrity exactly. Which one will it be?
Richard, please.
Richard it is, all right. Kathy, you face me that way. I will take the $10,000 question out of the card very carefully there, and here we go. Richard, are you ready?
Yeah.
Blank wash. W-A-S-H. Blank wash. Or blank wash. I'll give you both accents. Blank wash. Are you trying to communicate with him by mental telepathy?
It's not working.
Oh, it's not working? All right, blank wash. How do you fill in that blank in order to match him to collect the $10,000?
I could only think of clean wash.
Clean wash. The audience is awing, which may be a bad omen, but one never knows on this show. Let's find out right now. Richard, may we see it, please?
I swear I couldn't think of anything at all.
What?
No, I just kept going around. I couldn't think of the... There must be a certain one. I said dry and wash.
Dry and wash.
I couldn't... What is it? Tell me.
Car wash is the only...
Oh!
That's the only thing I could think of. Yeah.
Oh, that's what it is.
Car wash. I was trying to give it to both of you. But I failed.
Did that occur to you?
Kathy, you won a grand total of $1,000. That's better than nothing. You come right back after this message. Gene Rayburn Match Game PM. Join us next week. Goodbye.
Some contestants will receive cool coverage from Frederick, leader in energy, official room air conditioners. Frederick lasts for years, saves you a lot of money. And record a call, lady. Automatic telephone. Production.